This is going to be a really hard video to make. I'm sorry if there's background noise. I have my heater on. I'm freezing. I'm not feeling all that great right now. So I guess I just have to come out and say it. Last night I got the phone call that my dad has died. And I'm not really for sure exactly how to process that, which is why I turned on my camera, because it's the only coping mechanism I have, I guess, is to talk and let it out and share it. On one hand, I want to be careful with how I say things and what I say. On the other hand, I know that I need to get out my thoughts and feelings and deal with it that way too. It's weird. So I guess I'll just tell you how it went down. I got back from Cincinnati yesterday, met David here at the house, talked to him. After he took a shower, we decided to go out for dinner. It was really late. And as we were getting in the car, I got the call from my grandpa. And then my sister messaged me that that was probably what was going on. And I actually felt a huge relief. One I've never experienced before. I felt a lot of my emotional trauma just kind of pass away. In that moment, I felt I truly had the potential to make it. And for once, I didn't have a negative thought in my brain. A nagging voice just biting away at anything positive in my life. You know, when my grandpa told me, I think he was expecting, I felt that he felt I should have maybe had a stronger reaction or started crying or something, but I just said, okay, thanks for calling. That was it. And in that moment, I just felt lighter than a feather. This week, two nights in a row, I had dreams about my grandparents dying. And I knew something was up. I mean, you could just feel it in the air. I got the message actually Monday night that he was given a week or so. And then it was like the next day, yesterday, that happened. I don't want to be disrespectful. I don't want to be hateful. And I'm trying really hard to be good. I don't know what I'm trying to say. So I feel on one hand, I do want to get out my true emotions, my thoughts and feelings. On the other hand, I feel like I can't fully, but I'll try. I've shared with you guys the story and other stories if you've watched, but I feel like for me and my emotional well-being, this is a good thing. And because I have struggled with that every day of just my own negative thoughts and emotions toward anything, what I say, what I do, what I eat, what I wear, everything, it was exhausting and not fun to deal with, always criticizing yourself and being afraid that people are gonna leave you because of something stupid you do, or, you know, whatever it is. I feel like a lot of that's probably gone now, you know, because I don't have the one of two negative things in my life. And I don't have the other one either, but yeah, it's still around. But it was a moment for me when I just felt like I could breathe. So I was relieved in a way. I guess for my own selfish reasons. I don't know if it's selfish or consider taking care of myself, but I was relieved regardless. And then my heart started catching up, and I told David, I was like, I don't know, should I call my mom? Should I go see her? Should I just leave it? You know, talked to him, and I talked to a friend, and I made the decision to go on and go. My grandma was there, and some other people were there, my step-grandma. And so, it was weird. I walked in, and thank God my mom's friend warned me, because I didn't know. But he was just laying there on the couch, and he looked like he was sleeping. Except he was about as white as a ghost. I could have sworn I saw him breathing too. Like, it was weird. Normally, when I've seen a dead body, they've just gotten cold and stiff, and I didn't get that from him. I don't know, it was weird. It was about a couple hours before they came and got the body. And I wanted to be there when they did that for closure purposes, I guess. It was very, the whole day really was just so foreign. You know, going to Cincinnati, doing things out of my element, you know, dealing with traffic and all that, and then coming back to something of that magnitude. It was all very strange. Very strange. I talked a lot to David this week about how I've been dealing a lot with loneliness. And it's caused a whole lot of negative thoughts and feelings, and, you know, just feeling like you're isolated. You know, it's really difficult. And turns out he's been feeling the same way in ways, so we were able to, like, really kind of eventually connect and talk about it. And you know, that was nice that we had some kind of, you know, similarities going on with each other, that we were able to get together and talk. And that was nice. But it's something I've been dealing with a lot. And, you know, manifesting is not really the right word, but I just really started thinking about it on, like, a really deep level, and, you know, hoping that things turn around. And that's when I all of a sudden got a call from a friend saying, hey, you know, I'd like you to come over and hang out. And it was a friend that I've been wanting to reconnect with anyway. So that was super nice. Sorry, I'm freezing. And I just think that loneliness really started eating away at me. And, I don't know. It was just something I've been dealing with. And so I made the decision to go to my mother's house last night. I wanted to be a bigger person. I wanted to not, I'm just gonna be honest, I didn't want any bad karma my way. And I wanted closure. I wanted to see for myself. And I did. And now it's time to move on. I mean, I don't really know what to say other than the negativity I had in my life is now gone. And it's kind of refreshing. I feel like I can move on from some things, not all things, but from some things, because the issue no longer exists. And that's nice to know, because it gives me a certain peace about everything, really, everything. From bad childhood memories to bad young adult memories to memories I've had to deal with, you know, recently. You know, negative words and statements and just really things that can destroy you emotionally no longer have to exist. Like, I can literally just wash them away at this point. And it's a really good feeling to be able to let go. Like I said, I can't let go of everything, but I can let go of a lot of it. I feel bad that I don't feel bad. I want to mourn in a way that I feel is normal, but I can't because we didn't have really any type of relationship. No, never really, never. My grandpa, I considered my father. So, there's that. I'm sorry. I'm also going on 2 hours of sleep right now. I don't know what else to say. I know I need to say more. I know that I'm nowhere near done expressing myself and getting it out and dealing with it, but I really don't know what to say.